Hi, today we have come up with one more addition to our videos of IP CCTV series. In our early video, we had explained to configure IP camera to the network video recorder. And in this video, we will explain how you are going to connect IP CCTV camera directly to the PC or laptop. Not only you connect camera to the PC to view it live, but you can also record it on the PC and also control various parameters of the camera. So to start, we need an IP camera, a power adapter to provide power to the camera, and a patch cord, and finally a PC or laptop. So as you can see, this is our IP camera. This is a dome kind of camera, dome IP camera. This one is power adapter to provide power to the camera, and this is the patch cord through which we will connect our IP camera to the PC or laptop. So as you can see, this is the data connector of the IP camera, and this is one end of the patch cord. So we are going to connect this one end of the patch cord to the data connector of the IP camera, and the output power pin of the adapter is connected to the power input pin of the IP camera. So now we have made two connections. One is we have provided power to the IP camera, and another we have connected data connector of the camera to the one end of the patch cord. So another end of the patch cord will be connected to the LAN port of the laptop. So this is our laptop, and you can see here it is the LAN port. So we will connect it to the LAN port. So now you can see the another end of the patch cord is connected to the LAN port of the laptop. So let's review our connections. The output power pin of the power adapter is connected to the input power pin of the camera, IP camera, and data connector of the IP camera is connected to the patch cord, and another end of the patch cord is connected to the LAN port of the laptop. So let's go to our laptop screen. Here it is important to know that each IP camera comes with a default IP address, username and password. In our case, the default IP address of our camera is 192.168.1.11. In order to make communication between IP camera and the laptop, both the IP addresses, means the IP address of the laptop and the IP address of the camera, should be in the same series. For example, the IP address of our IP camera is 192.168.1.11, then IP address of laptop should be 192.168.1, and the last figure should be different from that of the IP camera, means the IP address of our laptop should be 192.168.1.95. So let's check if it is so or not. To check, go on this network icon at the bottom of the screen and right click on it, then click on Open Network and Sharing Center. Go to Change Adapter Settings, click on this, right click on Local Area Connection, then click on Properties, click on Internet Protocol version 4 and click on Properties. So you can see the IP address of our laptop is 192.168.0.95, means this address is not in the same series as that of the IP camera. The 0 here should be replaced with 1 in order to make it in the same series as that of the IP camera. So replace 0 with 1 and click on OK. Close all windows. Let's check whether we have succeeded in establishing the communication between IP camera and the laptop. For that, go to start and the search bar type CMD. Here type ping ping space IP address of our IP camera 192.168.1.11, then space minus T and press enter. You can see we are getting reply from IP camera. If you are getting this kind of reply from the IP camera, it means that the communication between the camera and the laptop is established. So far so good. Then close this. Now go to internet browser. In the address line here, type the IP address of the IP camera, that is 192.168.1.11, and press enter. If you are doing it for the first time, you will be prompted to download ActiveX plugin. Here you can see you are getting the prompt. Please download the web plugin control and install it when you log in the IP camera at the first time. Also at the bottom you can see this a message asking you to allow the installation of the plugin. So you will have to allow it and at the same time click on download. Again you are prompted whether you want to run or save the plugin. Just click on run. We need to close the internet browser first and click on retry. Click on next. Again next. Next again and install. So the ActiveX plugin is being installed. It's been successful. Click on finish. Now again open internet browser. Again type the IP address of the IP camera 192.168.1.11, press enter. It is important to know one more thing. Sometimes when you try to download the ActiveX plugin, Windows will block it from downloading. So in that case you will need to go to settings here at the top of the screen. Click on this, go to internet options. Click on this. Here go to security and go to internet and click on custom level. Here you need to enable some settings like ActiveX control plugin. You need to enable. Similarly, you need to enable download signed ActiveX control and also download unsigned ActiveX control. You need to enable this also, or you may keep it on prompt. So these are some settings that you need to enable and click OK. One more thing you can do, you go to trusted sites. Again click on sites, remove this check from the box and type https://192.168.1.11, which is the IP address of the IP camera, and add it. Close, apply and close this box. So now if you again try to download the ActiveX control, which previously Windows has blocked, then it will get downloaded. Now type username of the camera, that is admin, and the password 12345. Click on login. You are getting the message, the current password is too simple, please modify the password. We will do it later. So finally, your camera is online. So here, you have got a configuration button. In the configuration button, there are various parameters of the cameras which you can control. So these are all self-explanatory. The main configuration we would like to mention here, like if you want to change the IP address of the camera, you need to go to the network button, and here you can change the IP address of the camera just deleting and typing and saving. So these are basic configuration. Let's keep it out of the scope of this video. We come back to the live view. Here at the bottom of the screen, there is an icon to start recording the video, live video of the IP camera. Click on here and the recording is started. This button is basically to click on an image or a screenshot. Again, by clicking on this button, you can stop the recording. So the recording is done on the local laptop. You can check the path where it will be saved in the configuration. You can see save record files to. This is the path: C drive, IPC, and record. You can even change the path if it is required. So now we check if we have the recording file or not. Let's minimize this window. So let's go to the C drive. And to the folder IPC. There are two different folders, record and capture, one for the video file, another is for the image that we have captured. We can see here is our image file, and in under record folder we have got our video file. So today we have learned to configure the IP camera to the local PC without the need of the network video recorder, that is NVR. We have learned to configure various parameters of the camera, and also we have learned how to record the camera on the local PC. So this is the end of the video, and if you liked the video, kindly do share, subscribe and comment. It will motivate us to update with new videos, new educational videos. Thank you very much.